Hello and welcome to Tribble Bites. I'm your host, Meg Trast, bringing you the latest in Star Trek and Orville news. Now, before we dive in today, I would like to broadcast a reminder that Sci-Fi for Me has officially launched our Indiegogo page. You can learn more at scififorme.tv and see what kind of benefits you could get. Diving right in with some COVID updates, the Star Trek store at StarTrek.com is offering Trek-themed face masks. In this time of COVID-19, the Star Trek shop is offering 4 different Star Trek-themed face masks, and 100% of the proceeds of sales will go to Feeding America's COVID-19 response. The 4 masks include some fun designs, including Star Trek Picard Borg washable face mask, Star Trek The Original Series Delta, Star Trek The Original Series Enterprise, and Star Trek Picard Collage. All are to be washed after every use, but they are reusable. They are made of 100% 2-ply polyester and come in 2 sizes. You can find them at StarTrek.com. Now, speaking of COVID-related activities, the Star Trek Voyager cast reunion was held virtually, and they raised more than $19,000 for the Actors Fund on Stars in the House, which is an all-time record. Last week, the cast of Star Trek Voyager got together for a virtual 25th anniversary reunion. The live stream, part of the Stars in the House web series in support of the Actors Fund, took place last Tuesday and featured the entire main cast appearing in rotation and generally reminiscing about their time on the show. And now Deadline reports that donations from fans set a record for the most money ever raised for the Actors Fund in a single episode. The previous Stars in the House record was set by a Glee reunion episode, which raised around $13,000. So got that beat by about $6,000. Hosts Seth Rudetsky and James Wesley said it came as no surprise that the Trekkies showed up in full force to see the reunion. But we didn't know their generosity would be so great as to break the single episode fundraising record. Of course, it makes sense because the Star Trek franchise has always been about inclusivity and kindness, and we should have known that the values of the show are shared by Trekkies everywhere. Stars in the House airs new episodes daily at 2 p.m. and 8 p.m. Eastern on their YouTube channel and at starsinthehouse.com. And that Voyager cast reunion is archived there if you wanted to check it out and see what all the fuss is about. And in line with that, I know we've spoken previously about this, but apparently things are changing. Kate Mulgrew apparently would not actually mind reprising her role as Captain Catherine Janeway. Now, Mulgrew reportedly hasn't watched Picard yet, but in an interview with Trek Movie's Laurie Ulster, Mulgrew said about reprising her Janeway role, "Only because people are asking me about it all the time since Picard came on. When are you coming on? When are you coming back? When will we get Janeway on?" And she said, blah, blah, blah. On the web, somebody created an idea of what Janeway would look like, Mulgrew says, and it was actually quite stunning when I saw it. I think it would be wonderful to explore Janeway's continued love of adventure and perhaps even love of power. So there are any number of things that could be delicious to dip into, but I don't think it's going to happen. I'm not saying that summarily, but time's a-wastin', you know? Now, Mulgrew before had expressed an adamant disinterest in reprising her Janeway role. So it's interesting to see that she's actually interested in potentially bringing Janeway back. Now, I know we've seen a huge surge of reboots, and we will talk about that some more on Friday. We have talked about that before on Deep Space Minds, but we'll talk about it again. Mulgrew also said, "You just said that everybody is watching Star Trek. There's a reason for that. Acting is more than just acting. In situations like this," in reference to the COVID pandemic, You see that it is an imperative in the culture. And for some reason, and this is what we'll talk about largely, Star Trek signifies hope. And to pause there, Jason and I have pointed that out multiple times on Deep Space Minds. So I like that Mulgrew has said that same thing as well. Mulgrew also said, of course, the parallel is terrific, isn't it? A capsule lost in a dark and dangerous place, the Delta Quadrant, could really be a wonderful comparison to where we are now. The planet is jeopardized, I think, and everybody's scared and quite overcome by the magnitude of this pandemic, the perniciousness of it, and what it's going to cost us coming out the other end, and how will we survive? We survive with art, and this is an art that we cannot practice while we are contained like this. Back in March, Tim Russ tweeted a photo of the Voyager crew, sans Robert Beltran, along with the caption, "My Voyager castmates from the Trek cruise. It was good to see them again." So Mulgrew, reminiscing about this tweet, also expressed disappointment that further 25th anniversary events will be canceled this year due to the pandemic. But in brighter news, she's working on a novel during quarantine, which we will keep tabs on here at Sci-Fi for Me. So make sure you stay tuned to see what's going on with that. Now moving on to our next story, rumors. More to do with Star Trek Picard. Rumor has it that Will Wheaton will make an appearance in Star Trek Picard in a reprisal of his Wesley Crusher role. If that were to happen, it would likely be in season 3. We all know Wheaton is highly active in the Star Trek fan community, but he himself isn't the biggest fan of Wesley Crusher. So once again, that's a rumor we'll have to keep an eye out for here on Sci-Fi for Me, and we will keep you updated on Tribble Bytes if any official news comes out of that. But for now, it's unsubstantiated, just rumors, so we're just talking about it because wouldn't that be interesting to see Wesley Crusher all grown up? In less fortunate news, Richard Hurd passed away Tuesday, May 26th from cancer-related causes at his home in Los Angeles. He was 87 years old. Now, Star Trek fans will best know Hurd for his role as Admiral Owen Paris in Star Trek Voyager, father of Tom Paris, who was played by Robert Duncan McNeil. He also, earlier in Star Trek, played the role of the Klingon Lakor in the Star Trek The Next Generation episodes Birthright Part 1 and Birthright Part 2. Outside of Star Trek, Hurd was probably best known for his role as Mr. Wilhelm on Seinfeld. He also played William Shatner's boss, Captain Sheridan, on TJ Hooker. Hurd's other roles include Supreme Commander John on the 80s miniseries V, as well as supporting roles in the films All the President's Men, Planes, Trains, and Automobiles, Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil, and many, many others. Hurd's extensive film and television career spanned 5 decades, from 1970 up to just last year. Hurd is survived by his wife Patricia, daughter Erica, son Rick, and stepdaughter Alicia. We here at Sci-Fi for Me TV offer our condolences to his family and bid yet another great actor farewell. Moving on to brighter news and another charity event, Star Trek Online and Neverwinter raised $130,000 last month. In May, Perfect World Entertainment, the publisher of Star Trek Online and its sister game Neverwinter, announced that it would be raising money for 2 charities by offering exclusive digital bundles. The promotion ended last week. In the promotion, players could purchase codes for exclusive digital items in Neverwinter and Star Trek Online for either the PC or gaming console versions. The total of $130,313 that was raised from the sale was split evenly between the 2 charities. On May 27th, we had an exciting space event, and NASA tweeted a thank you to our very own Captain Kirk, William Shatner, for his well wishes concerning the launch last week. Shatner said, "Wow, we're making history again," and wished the shuttle crew a safe journey there and home. And the link to that video is in our show notes if you wanted to check out William Shatner talking about the launch. IDW's summer publishing schedule includes a new Star Trek comic. Issue number 2 of 4 of Star Trek Deep Space Nine, Too Long a Sacrifice, coming to you this August. It is written by Scott and David Tipton and features art by Greg Scott and cover art by Ricardo Drummond. And the blurb reads, "Everyone is a suspect on a space station one murder away from plunging into total chaos. Constable Odo has a suspect in his sights, but there's one final piece to this dark puzzle that will change everything he thought he knew, not to mention life on Deep Space Nine forever. The shocking conclusion." I don't know how much of a conclusion issue 204 can be, but you can find out in August on the IDW website. Now, back to the same old, as COVID delays continue. It looks like the Orville Season 3 may not arrive still until 2021. Of course, as always, we will keep you updated here at Sci-Fi for Me. Now, don't forget to subscribe to Sci-Fi for Me here on YouTube. Hit that bell so you don't miss any updates. And if you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and a share. You can also find us on social media like Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and you can like us there to stay updated. Don't forget to check out our campaign at scififorme.tv. Everyone, please stay safe. Stay home if you can. Do all the things you're supposed to be doing to take care of yourself and the people that you love. Don't forget to just come see us on Friday for Star Trek Deep Space Minds. Until next time, live long and prosper.
You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV.